ओमज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय सदाले कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। त्वत्त्वा तूर्णमशेषमण्डलपतिं श्रेणीं सदा तुच्छवत् भूत्वा दीनगणेशकौ करुणया कोऽपि न कण्ठाशितौ गोपी भावरसामृतावलहरी कल्लोलमग्नमुहुः। वंदे रूप सनातनो भटयुगो श्रीजीव गोपालको। अजानुलंबितो भुजो कनकवदातो संकीर्तने कपित्रो कमलायताक्षो। विशंबरो द्विजवरो युगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणावतारो। जयतां सुतपंगुर मम मंदमतिर्गति मत्सर्वस्पदाम्भुजो श्रीराधामदनमोहि। भक्त्या विहीनाय अपराधलक्षे क्षिप्तस्य कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयी तं शरणं प्रपन्न वृन्दे नमस्ते शरणारविन्दम्। वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दम्। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। बोलो हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। By the mercy of Gurudev and Vaishnav, we are hearing Sri Radha Tattva. We heard from Chaitanya Charitamrita. We started from Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. Sri Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami explaining the details of Radha Tattva. But then Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in his commentary, and Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, in his commentary Anubhashya, he is giving details of the qualities of Radharani. And while discussing that, while hearing that, we came to this very beautiful subject. Radharani is Krishna's pleasure-giving potency, which cannot be separated from Krishna. But Krishna, with his own desire, he manifested his Haladini Shakti, his pleasure-giving potency, and that Haladini Shakti assume a form that is Radharani. Haladini Shakti. So we heard few qualities. Remember where we started? Charu Sobhagya Rekhadeya Gandod Madhut Madhava Sangeet Parasar Abhigya Ramme Vak Narma Pandita Vinita Karna Purna Vidagya Pattanvita. Right? We came to this point. And द प्लेजर गिविंग पोटेंसी का कृष्णस्य प्रणय जनिबु श्रीमती राधिका एक का अस्य प्रियस्य अनुपम गुना राधिका एक नाचा अन्यम श्री कविराज गोस्वामी एक्सप्लेनिंग इन गोविंद लीलामृत द ओरिजिन ऑफ प्रणय द अफेक्शन द लव इज ओनली श्रीमती राधिका हु गिव्स ऑल हर endeavors are there to please Krishna. Therefore, what is that prem which Krishna want to highlight to the entire universe? What is that prem that Krishna bow his head down and he folded hands in saying that Na pareham nirvadya samyajam. O Radharani, I cannot repay your debt. Debt of what? Debt of sacrifices? No. The debt of pain. And Krishna wanted to know this. What is that pain? So na jane Radha prem ache kotubal. Se bale ama sada kare vipal. That prem of Radharani bewilders me. I get overwhelmed by seeing and want to understand what is that prem. So just a brief introduction of what we have heard till now. And we are hearing what Radharani has to speak about this prem. So this very nice verse explained by Shri Vishwanath Chakur Thakur. Lokadvayat swajanta parato satova pran priyadapi sumeru sama yadi seyu kleshat kleshatadyadapi bali sahas vijitaya premevatan harin bhanev pushti meti. Meaning, just as a lion defeats elephants and nourishes itself by eating them. Elephant is so powerful, so much strength. But lion jumps off the head of elephant, jumps on the head of elephant and eat him. Lion. How powerful is lion? But in comparison, what we see? Elephants, they are very powerful, right? But lion is more powerful. Elephant can't eat lion. Lion eats the elephant. Just as a lion defeats elephants and nourishes itself by eating them, lion gets so much because he's very strong and powerful. He gets pleasure by eating elephants. And to just show off how powerful I am, by not only killing elephant, but eating elephant. In India, there is one state, northeast, where I used to go for Bhagavad Sapta, and it's all jungle around. So the local residents there, they used to tell me that Maharaj, in this month, December and January, 250 or 300 elephants comes all together in our town, in our village, in our fields to eat paddy, to eat rice, etc. Because in winter, they don't get anything to eat there. So, farmers are always getting trouble. So, they have some very powerful spotlights. They are in the field. Whole night, they stay in the field. and they have a very powerful spotlight to scare elephants. And also sometimes they have fireworks. By hearing that, elephants, they run away. 250, imagine how many elephants, 300 sometimes. And then in that jungle also, lion, tiger, leopard, all these ferocious animals. They say whenever we notice, even though so many elephants comes here, but if a lion enters also to the field to eat something and roars so loudly, elephant gets scared. This shows lion is more powerful than elephant. So I personally saw small cubs of lioness. The mother, she gave birth, and we all there, and the newly born cubs are like cats, small cats, and we took in our hand like this. Similarly, this extremely powerful brain nourishes itself by conquering the unlimited and difficult miseries caused by conditions in this world, by other planets, by family members, by enemies, by one's own body, or by matters related to the body, and even by troubles caused by one's beloved that are as unsurmountable as Mount Sumeru. Okay. So just like a lion defeats elephants and nourishes itself by eating, similarly, this prem is very powerful. The comparison of prem here is with lion. And the comparison of elephants is all of obstacles or the miseries which come on the way of prem. So he's explaining, Vishnu Chakur Thakur explaining, similarly, Radharani is saying this to Krishna. Similarly, this extremely powerful prema nourishes itself. How? By feeling pleasure. And how feeling pleasure? By conquering or by killing what? Unlimited and difficult miseries caused by conditions in this world. This prema get nourished, the prema get pleasure by killing that elephant. Elephant of what? Elephant like the unlimited and difficult miseries caused by this material world. By other planets. You know, sometimes some planets not in a favorable direction, not in a favorable house in the astrology, gives so much trouble. That's the challenge of prem. That's the challenge comes from prem. Still that prem exists, still that prem remains, or that prem gets destroyed. So one elephant here is, elephant-like comparison is, the unlimited and difficult miseries caused by conditions in the world. Second, by planets. Third, by family members. Fourth, by enemies. And fifth, by one's own body. Understand? Or by matters related to the body. These are all compared to as elephant. And prema is compared to as lion. But there is something more. And even what to speak of all these 5, 6 we just counted. But even by the troubles caused by one's own beloved that are as unsurmountable as Mount Sumeru. Mount Sumeru is very high, more high than Himalayas. Sun, Suryadev, goes around Mount Sumeru, and that's why we get day and we get night. Sun rides on his chariot and goes around Mount Sumeru. So that portion where the sun with seven wheels goes around Sumeru and gets day. And the other portion, other part, remains dark like night. But not only day and night of this universe, I mean this world, but the complete universe. Complete universe. And that's the reason in Srimad Bhagavatam, Priyavrata Maharaj, he saw why we get day and we get night. And he came to know that Suryadev, sun, he goes around Mount Sumeru. And the portion and the part where Mount Sumeru, the Suryadev goes around Sumeru gets day, another portion gets night. So Priyavrata Maharaj also, he also created one chariot and he wanted there should not be any nights. Every time it should be daylight. So Suryadev is on his chariot with seven wheels, and Priyavrata Maharaj, the king Priyavrata, the son of Swayambhu Manu, following the Suryadev, making all those parts which are dark, night also as daylight. So how big is Mount Sumeru? How tall is Mount Sumeru? No one can count that. So that's why Radharani is saying that even troubles caused by one's beloved that are compared to as Mount Sumeru. All other troubles are compared to as elephant. Very powerful, but it's easy to conquer that. Because prema should be like lion, powerful. On the other side, the troubles caused by one's beloved is like Mount Sumeru. So the explanation of this is, Sri Radhika is explaining that prema is inherently free from obstacles. Who is explaining this? Radharani. Sri Radhika explaining that prema is inherently free from obstacles. There is no obstacles in prema. Once it has manifested, not even hundreds of thousands of obstacles can obstruct it. Once it is manifested, once it is developed, then hundreds of thousands of obstacles can come, can't obstruct the path of prema. It just flow in one, it just go in one flow. In such prema, there is no place for concern about worldly comforts, religious duties, the attainment of residence in heaven, and so forth. So those Radharani saying about that prema. Many people, ordinary people, who don't understand the philosophy and who have no access to that prema of Radharani, what Radharani is expressing, they think this is something absurd. This is something it's not bona fide. This is something very wrong. Because they have no clear understanding the position of Radharani. They don't know what is that prema. So therefore, they say Radharani, she is just like an and gopis, they are very lusty for Krishna. But Sri Rupa Goswami Pad explains in Ujjvalin Premeva Goparamanam Kamya Iti Agvan Pratham Iti Uddhav Ado Vanchanti Bhagavat Priya. The word lust, which we hear in this material world, the word lust for Radharani is her prem. Although it appears same, but there is so much difference. Darkness and sunshine. Kam prem bhavantar, kam andatam. Kam andatam, prem nirmal bhaskar. Lust, kam is like darkness. And prem is effulgent sun. So they don't understand this. If Radharani prem is lust, means self-motivated, then why all great personalities like Uddhav and all others, they want to have the food dust of Radharani? Why they want to have this? Iti Uddhavado Vanchanti. Uddhav and all others, they are longing to get this stuff. Because this prem is pure. So, in such prem, there is no place for concern about worldly comforts. Radharani Singh. That means one should be ready to tolerate this. If you get worldly comforts, you may not get worldly comforts. Don't depend on this. When the prem is the center, then it cannot be destroyed. But when all other things are in center, that's not unconditional prem. That's conditional love, conditional prem. So no place for concern about worldly comforts, religious duties. The attainment of residence in heaven and so forth. Arthad, in other words, no space for dharma, arth, kam and moksha. The four purusharthas, no room for that. Only pancham purusharth, Krishna prem, that's all. Only for the pleasure of my beloved Krishna, that's all. So if we understand this, do gopis, they care for their worldly comforts? No. They care for religious duties? No. And the direct example of this is when Krishna, he called upon gopis and all the gopis came running there. And Krishna, he tried to scare them by putting forth some religious fear to the gopis. What is that? Go and serve your husbands. It's not proper for all of you to come in midnight to see me. Go and serve your husbands. Even though husband is Tushilo, Turbhago, Vriddho, Jad Roko, Adhan, Apiva. The attainment of residence in heaven and so forth. Reapproaches by family members and abuse by enemies cannot enter the ears, and one even forgets to protect one's own body. Prema has absolutely no obstacle. Prema has absolutely no obstacle. Even the lover's own attempts to break it by neglecting his beloved's love do not act as an obstacle to prema. Understand? So, this is a warning again and again. What we are hearing, this is prema of Radharani for Krishna. She is explaining her own prema. She is explaining that which is in her heart for what Krishna is longing for to see. She is opening that, opening that box, the box which is locked and she is hiding in her heart, and in which this very effulgent jewel called prema is kept there. Even the lover's own attempt to break it by neglecting his beloved's love do not act as an obstacle to prema. It's not even obstacle to prema. And that's why Sri Rupa Goswami explains in Sri Ujjwal Nirmani. I'm repeating this verse so many times. Sarvatha dhvansa rahitam satyapi dhvansa karane. When the deep emotion that binds a young couple does not break despite many reasons, it is called prema. No matter what happens, it does not break despite many reasons. In fact, multitudes of difficulties nourish prema rather than obstruct it. That's the difference. What we say prema in material world and what we say prema in spiritual world, that's the difference. In fact, multitudes of difficulties nourish prema rather than obstruct it. When so many obstruction comes on the way of prema, it enhances more and more. So many obstructions come, obstacle comes, then the prema gets more and more condensed, but it never breaks. Just like if the current of a quickly flowing river is obstructed, like in I don't know about other countries, in India we have dam, so they obstruct the flow of water in a river. They create a dam, they obstruct, they close by something, they close the flow of the river. So water is just stopped by something, by some device. But moment someone opens that door of that obstruction, of that thing, water flows more speed, 5 times, 10 times more speed than the ordinary regular speed. So, Sri Chakravarti Thakur explaining, if the current of a quickly flowing river is obstructed, the water will overcome the obstruction and flow with redoubled force. 2 times more, 5 times more, goes more far when there is some obstruction. Similarly, attraction for the beloved increases in proportion to the obstacles encountered. The attraction for the beloved increases in proportion to the obstacles encountered. As many obstacles come, the prema goes increase on more proportionately. As a result, the force of that prema increases 100-fold. That's why শিল ভক্তিবিনোদ ঠাকুর দিচ্ছেন, তোমার সেবায় দুঃখ হয় যত সেই তো পরম সুখ। তোমার সেবায় দুঃখ হয় যত সেই তো পরম সুখ। সুখ দুঃখ ও কৃষ্ণ, তোমার সেবায় দুঃখ হয় যত। অল দোজ অবস্ট্যাকলস উইচ কাম অন মাই ওয়ে টু সার্ভ ইউ, দ্যাটস সেই তো পরম সুখ, দ্যাটস দ্য সোর্স অফ মাই গ্রেট হ্যাপিনেস, বিকজ মাই অবজেক্ট অফ লভ ইজ ইউ কৃষ্ণ। সো সো মেনি অবস্ট্যাকলস কামস also given by Krishna. What we heard just now, by the planets, worldly comforts, or by the beloved himself. But prema goes far, far and far more. Shri Bilmangal Thakur, he plucked his eyes out because he got attracted to see a beautiful woman. He plucked his eyes, he became blind. He didn't care for his bodily comforts, but he just took out that obstruction, because that's the only obstruction between him and Krishna. He felt like that. And therefore, Rupa Goswami Pad, he he declared, he explained, Bilvangar Thakur to be a sadhaka. He's a sadhaka. But when he became blind, he's walking towards Vrindavan, and Krishna came to hold his hand and showing the path to Vrindavan. In that state of bodily discomfort, how can we imagine a person who just plucked his own eyes out, get blind? Pain on happiness. Pain or not. But in that state of condition, Bilvangar Thakur is reciting verses which are pleasing to the ears of Krishna, called Krishna Karnamrit, explaining the beauty of Krishna, the ornaments of Krishna, the peacock feather of Krishna, the flute of Krishna, all details of Krishna, Krishna Karnamrit. Because the object of his fame, means Sri Krishna, was just with him. So this bodily discomfort, that obstruction, did not destroy his fame. But it got 100 times more than it was before. The great sage Bharat Muni, who is the original guru of the scripture on Ras, has explained this phenomenon as follows. You have heard of this great dance called Bharatanatyam. Who originated this? This great sage Bharat Muni. He wrote scriptures, he wrote shastras on ras. But which kind of ras? Prakrit ras, material prema. Shri Kaviraj Goswami explains in Chaitanya Charitamrita, तुहु जे समरस भरत पुनी माने अमार ब्रज प्रेम से नहीं जाने। भरत मुनि वेरी फेमस, ही रोट ऑल दी स्क्रिप्चर्स ऑन काम रस, मटेरियल प्रेम, एंड ही एक्सप्लेन इन दैट दैट loved and beloved, they have same love for each other. Duhu je samaras Bharat Muni mane, amar braj prem se nahi jane. Krishna saying this. He don't know anything about my braj ras. The ras of braj, he don't know. Because he's saying both are same, equally. But braj is different. In the braj ras, the predominance of Radharani's love is superior than Krishna. Krishna is beloved of Radharani. And for Krishna's pleasure, she embraced all these obstructions for Krishna's pleasure. Because these obstructions are coming on my way, and by this, embracing them, my love for Krishna enhances more and more and more. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, Amar Brajrasi se nahi jane. He don't know. He don't know anything about my Brajras. Because it's not equal. Radharani love is more. It's so superior than Krishna that Krishna is even hankering for that love. The Supreme Personality Krishna hankering for that love. So this is a description of Bharat Muni. So Bharat Muni, he wrote scriptures on rasa, prema rasa, but prakrit, material prema rasa. And Sri Rupa Goswami also wrote everything on rasa, bhakti rasamrit sindhu. But Rupa Goswami wrote rasa scripture, rasa shastra, not explaining any prakrit, material prema. But he explained all about the aprakrit, transcendental, effulgent, spiritual, the prem between Radha and Krishna. Not ordinary prem. So he overruled, Sri Rupa Goswami overruled Bharat Muni. So some people following Bharat Muni, his prakrit, his ordinary description of prem, that's not bona fide. We follow Rupa Goswami because he explained transcendental prema, spiritual prema, and the prema between not an ordinary nayak or a nayika, hero and heroine, but prema between the best hero, the best nayak, Sri Krishna, and nayika, Radharani, which is Krishna's own pleasure giving potency, which is Krishna himself, but his Shakti, Radharani. Understand? Bahu varyate yata khalu yatra prachanna kam uptamam cha yacha mitho durvalata sa man mathasya paramarati. Again, I'm telling, these topics are very high. Understand? So just don't take it so lightly or thinking, oh, now I understand the meaning of prema. No, this is Radharani explaining about prema. We are only hearing this as a philosophical understanding to overcome and to defeat that ordinary prema, which people think this is everything. They think this prema is everything. There's nothing beyond that. Okay. But even demigods have no access to that. Even rishis have no access to that. Only bhaktas. Which bhaktas? Those who are following the footsteps of Lalita Sakhi, who is assisting in the meeting of Radha and Krishna. And she, Rupa Goswami. So we are only trying to understand the philosophical part, but we should not imitate this. Understand? But Atashi Krishna Namadi Nambhaved Grajendriyai सेवन मुखे ही जीवादो स्वयं में श्रुते मनः. वी कैनॉट अंडरस्टैंड और परसीव दिस हाई टॉपिक्स बट जस्ट हियरिंग और स्पीकिंग. बट सेवन मुखे ही जीवादो वेन अवर सेंसेस इन अ मूड ऑफ सर्विस ऑफ कृष्णा एवरी टाइम एवरी एक्ट इज सर्विस. Even studying, even living together, preaching, singing, cooking, whatever it is, when all the activities are there with this only mood in the heart, I'm serving Krishna directly or indirectly, or a lamentation, lamenting that I'm not able to serve Krishna. I'm wasting my life, I'm wasting my day, I'm wasting my time. I come across many devotees. So why we are working? We are working 8 hours, 10 hours, why? Oh, why we are not getting this opportunity to all the time serve Krishna by read about Krishna, by reading about Krishna, by hearing about him, by doing any services to him, any preaching, just go in the street, distribute books. We have no time because we have to take care of family. They are lamenting for that. So when all the senses are there to only with the mood of serving Krishna, then swim this the mercy, you know, the name, form, qualities, pastimes reflects on the senses of the sadhaka. That's called experience. And that experience called realization. So everyone's experience and realizations are not same. It differs person to person in proportion to how much we have surrendered our time and our life to Krishna. Then we can understand this. So someone may ask question, why we are reading this, which is such a difficult subject? Just to know the philosophical facts, which makes us very strong in our understanding, in our sadhana. What is actually the definition of word prema? When Radharani is saying this to Krishna and describing in detail the definition of the word prema, how much strength this is giving to us. We can't compare ourselves with Radharani. That's something stupid if we just think like that. But is also giving us or inspiring us with a hint, that how to love Krishna, because Krishna prema is our priyojan. Krishna is not our priyojan. Understand? Krishna is not our object of the aim and object of our life, whereas Krishna prema is aim and object of life. So by hearing what Radharani has to describe about prema, that's why we took this topic. For better understanding, let us hear from the right source what prema is about. And we are just trying, trying to understand and taking some small steps to get this. We start with Shravan Kirtan Smaran. Starts with hearing Shunvatam Swakatha Krishna Punya Shravan Kirtane Punya Shravan Krishna Kirtane Hidayantustai Havadrani Vinotim Surin Satam. First, the heart has to be clean with all impurities, all envious mood, all other anger, lust, anger, greed, envious, is full. Heart is full with that. Then how can Krishna prema can reflect in this heart with all impurities? So by hearing this, there is some inspiration. There is a better understanding. What Radharani is, what she is saying means she is preaching. What Radharani is saying here about prema is she is preaching about prema. And that preaching of Radharani is fully explained by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, where Krishna is explaining the definition of prema. And all his shiksha, his teaching is only to describe or to attain the prema. Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita and he gave some hints there. Manmanam bhav madbhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru. Time, place and circumstance. He spoke karma yoga, he spoke bhakti yoga, he spoke jnana yoga. Some little hints. Can't express everything. But acharyas like Krishna Chakur Thakur, Vaknir Thakur, Srila Gurudev, they extracted the meaning of Krishna. Actually, what Krishna wanted to say is prema, that's all. But when Krishna came as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, adopting the mood and complexion of Radharani, he spoke directly. Prem dhan vina vyarth daridra jivan, das kori vetan mor deha prema dhan. Without prema, this life is poor. This life has no meaning. Das kori vetan mor. Make me a servant and give me this. Give me this prema dhan, the wealth of prema. And even after going through so many transcendental ecstasies and relishing this prema in such high state, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, na prema gandha asti durapam niharo. Who said this word? Radharani is saying this. Na prema gandha asti durapam niharo. I don't even have a tinge of prema in me. I don't even have a tinge of prema in me. Radharani is saying this. But here she is explaining the definition of word prema and the meaning of the word prema. But even after she knows everything about prema, she is the principal in that university of prema. She is the principal. No one can be beyond her. But prema also gives humbleness, the mood of humility. And in that mood of humility, Radharani expressed, na prema gandho asti durapi maiharo. Kandrami subhagyam prakashitam, vamshi vilas ananya lokam vinam, vivanti yad pran patanga yatha. I don't even have a tinge of prema in me. But whenever you see some tears in my eyes, this is just an exhibition that I want to show off. Oh, how glorious I am. So, what Bharat Muni is saying, the prema that is strongly objected to, the prema that is strongly objected to by society and religion, in which the Nayak means lover and beloved Nayaka must hide their amorous desires, and in which loving union is difficult to attain, is called Manmat Sambandita Parma Priti, the supreme passionate affection. This is a verse from Sri Ujjwal Nilmani Rupa Goswami. Bahu varyate yatah khalo yatra prachanna kamuktvam cha yacha mittho durlabhata cha manmathasya paramarapihi. The prema that is strongly objected to by society and religion, in which the Nayak, the lover, and beloved Nayika must hide their amorous desires, and in which loving union is difficult to attain. They can't see each other, they can't meet each other, they can't speak to each other. It's so difficult to attain. It's called Manmat Sambandhita Paramapiti, the supreme passionate affection. Supreme passionate affection. So Vishnu Chakra Thakur ends up by saying, therefore it is seen that a multitude of obstacles nourishes prema rather than inhibits it. The multitude of obstacles, many obstacles, only nourish prema, never diminish prema. And this is what the verse was about. Lokadwad sajanto. Lokadwad sajanto padata swato va. Pran priyadapi sumeru sama yadi sayu. Just like a lion, feel pleasure and get nourished by killing elephants. Similarly, this prem also. Feel pleasure and nourish by overcoming all other obstacles. It gets more and more condensed, not diminish. That's the difference between actual pain. But rather, I'm explaining this. So, it's all matter of Sharanagati. When we surrender to Krishna by following the 9 links of bhakti, which is very important, because by following 9 links of bhakti, what happens? Nav bhajan vande shesht nav vida bhakti Krishna prem Krishna dite dhare mahashakti. We are hearing the topic about prema, right? So what are the activities? What should be the activities by which we can get access with this prema? Bhajan madhye shesh navvida bhakti. By following navvida bhakti, what will happen? Krishna prem Krishna dite dhare mahashakti. The great potency, the great shakti in this navvida bhakti to give us Krishna prem. We will try to observe this Purushottam month coming soon. Every day, without failure, performing Navvida Bhakti. Shravan, Kirtan, Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasya, Sakhyam, Atman Nivedanam. Hearing about Krishna means hearing Harikatha. Then, speaking about Krishna. Speaking about Krishna means chanting more and more, as much as we can possible. No other gossip, no other topics. Just we are trying. Try at least 1 month. Let's see what happens. Maybe this COVID will go away. Because distancing from gossips and if there is any desire to speak, just put your face mask. Means mouth shut. And if there is any criticism to hear from someone, then sanitize. Sanitize yourself. No criticism. Only and only 1 month spending all time in chanting, hearing about Krishna, serving the deities. If you don't have deities, just picture. Just clean them, wipe them to Aarti, Mangal Aarti or Evening Aarti, 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, anytime. As much as one can do according to work situations. Prepare some bhoga for Krishna with a mood to only please him, not that, oh, I like puri, that's why I will cook for Krishna. No, it's pleasing to him. And whatever I prasad get in return, I will accept and honor this prasad, respectively given by Krishna. So many things we have to give up in this month. Tomato, eggplant, urad dal, mustard seed, all these details. Honey. So, following this very strictly and maintain purity. So, smaranam, vandanam, every day try to pray to Krishna. And what's the best way to pray Krishna is song book. Read the songs. If you can't sing, doesn't matter. Krishna knows the heart. He's not focusing on melody. He knows our heart. So if we can't sing, just we can read the translation. Manare. So if we don't know melody, if we can't sing, just translation. Oh mind, just speak about Gaura. Gaura's name is the abode of nectar and the embodiment and bestower of divine love. Shayane Gaura, Sapane Gaura, Gaura Nayane Tara, Jivane Gaura, Marane Gaura, Gaura Galarahara. In sleep, there is Gaura. In dreams, there is Gaura. God is the star of my eyes. In life, there is Gaura. In death, there is Gaura. Gaura is the most precious necklace. In life, there is Gaura. In death, there is Gaura. In sleep, Gaura. It's so difficult. In sleep, we see so many dreams. But the question is, do we see our deities in our dream? Maybe some devotees. But some devotees or non-devotees, they express they see some ghosts in the dream. They see some relatives or those who are already left this world, see them in the dream. But if we can only see Gaura, and once upon a time it happened, one devotee, he take this seriously, he took this seriously and he practiced chanting 3 lakh Harinam, 300,000 Harinam every day. And he tried this for 10 days. And then he expressed his realization. He said, whenever I'm sleeping 5 hours, 4 hours in night, I'm always hearing that Maha Mantra resounding, all the time hearing it, even in the sleep. Because if you chant 20 hours a day, or we can say, okay, 15 hours a day, what are we going to hear all the time? Again, Maha Mantra. So I know it's not that easy. It's easy to say. But in this month, Purushottam month, they're going to be 2 Ekadashis. So just 2 Ekadashis, if we do, we try chanting 3 lakh names. 64 rounds multiply by 3. And see how we feel. Just for 2 days on Ekadashi, on this Purushottam month. So prayers, how our Acharyas Bhaktivinoda Thakur explained, Narottam Thakur explained, we can read the meaning if we can't, if we don't know how to sing that. While cooking, while even in shower, while cleaning, while driving, we can hear songs. We can hear books. In this way, we can observe Purushottam month. Because by following this, Navida Bhakti, what will happen? Krishna Prem Krishna Dite Dhare Mahashakti. In his Krishna Bhai. Gaur Premanandi. Hari Hari Bol. Maroshi Radha Rani Ki Jai. If we follow Purushottam month, Srila Gurudev used to say this. If we worship Krishna, who will be pleased? Radharani. And then Kartik month. If we follow Kartik month also like this, to please Radharani, then who will be get pleased? Krishna. So this year, so many things happened this year. But we can also get mercy of Radharani by following Purushottam month and mercy of Krishna by observing Kartik month. And then very soon, we have Gaur Purnima. Then combined, Radha Bhavaduti Suvalitam, Naomi Krishna Sarupam. Combined form of Radha and Krishna, Mahaprabhu. Okay. So, there is one request to all devotees. Many of you are disciples of Srila Gurudev and many of you have not even seen him. But all of you have heard a lot about Srila Gurudev from many preachers speaking the glories of Gurudev. Right? So next year is the centennial year of Srila Gurudev. Means his 100th birth anniversary, as we say in ordinary way. So centennial year. And devotees, we all planned big celebrations for the next year. But because of this unwanted circumstances of COVID, etc., everything is just, you know, gone far away of all the plannings what we had. But we are using the best means with this digital smartphones, etc. We are hearing so much about Gurudev. So it's a request, all devotees, to write some glories of Gurudev, whatever you have heard from preachers or those who are disciples of Gurudev, whatever you have personally experienced by with him, or he gave any instructions to you, any pastime, any Guru Tattva, anything which changed your life, which appealed you a lot, or any loving exchanges with Gurudev. Just anything. And there is no limits. You can even write one line. Just one line. One line means, Gurudev, I want to serve you. Or you can write one complete book. There is no limit. As much, as many words, as many pages as you can write. I just got a message yesterday. They asking my help to spread this word to everyone. I said, of course, I will do this. And they said, Maharaj, there is no limit. But of course, there is a limit, there is a date. And the date is 15th November. We have to submit this before 15th November. But that's 15th November is too far. When they said 15th November, I said, okay, that's fine. I will not forget this date. But we can submit this in 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, whatever we think while chanting, meditating on Gurudev, any Harikatha, whatever. Okay? Any devotees, young devotees, senior devotees, you can write this. So, after some time, I'm going to send you one message where you have to submit all your writings. Okay? In this way, we can offering our Pushpanjali, our flowers at the lotus feet of our Gurudev in the form of our emotions and sentiments. And this will be encouraging and nice reading for the devotees worldwide. Oh, let me see what Taruni wrote. Let me see what Jayashree wrote. Everyone going to read what she wrote, what he wrote. And by reading all this, we get more and more close to Gurudev by reading the experiences of devotees, personal experiences, or by hearing experiences. Just like yesterday we went to, you all have seen that, yeah, Tomskin Square Park. You all saw that tree where we had program? Yes. So we were very fortunate and lucky we went there. Imagine, that's not an ordinary place. That's the dham. So while I was sitting here, I was thinking, Pushottam month is coming. I'm not visiting any holy river, any holy dham. Where I can find holy dham in New York? Then I say, oh, yeah, we have holy dham. What can be more holy dham than this? Bhakta pada dhuli, bhakta pada jal. The dust of the lotus feet of pure devotee, Acharya, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada. So therefore we, all devotees came, there was nice program. We did parikrama of that tree, we worship, we offer flowers. So even though everywhere else was all materialistic people around smoking and all, but devotees felt something very strong, vibrations there. Yes, I understand. So even though I never saw Srila Swami Maharaj in my life, I'm very unfortunate in that regard. I was not that lucky. Because when he left this world, I was only 5 years young boy. So didn't got chance to see him. But we can say, yes, we saw him. We are seeing him. How? By hearing about him. By reading about him. By hearing his glories. By hearing his contributions. His service mood. His surrender mood. Going through so many obstacles. But never deviated from the service mood to please the mission of Mahaprabhu. So much inspiration just by hearing about him. So in this way we can see them. Similarly, they are unlimited glories of Srila Gurudev. A very strong, prominent Acharya who descended from spiritual world to give us what? Radha Dasyam. Preach to us Gaudiya philosophy. Very strict, very straight Gaudiya philosophy. Preach to us and made us aware of this, of these scriptures, these books written by Goswami, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Jayav Dharam, Srila Prabhupada, his Param Gurudev, all this. Therefore, there are so many, more than 10,000 lectures of Srila Gurudev. And the team is working day and night to preserve those lectures. Soon going to be available for everyone. So this is how we can't repay him, but we can offer our heartfelt flowers at his lotus feet by remembering him. So devotees, take your pen, start thinking and writing. Okay? Or you can all email to me. This also can be done and I will forward to them. this can also be done. Okay. Mother Shila Guru Deva ki jai. Shri Radha Rani ki jai. See you all tomorrow.